Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us. Our presider today is our pastor, Father Fernando Molina Restrepo, and the Mass is concelebrated by our parochial vicar, Father Brian McNavish.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Greetings to all of you who are joining us from home via internet. Thank you for, you know, praying with us and being connected with us. Today we are celebrating the solemnity of the Ascension, and we are getting closer to end the Easter season. So, as we do always at the beginning of the Mass, we ask first for mercy and forgiveness for our sins.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Kyrie eleison. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Kyrie eleison.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving, for the ascension of Christ, your Son, is our exaltation, and where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, It is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly, two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. Joy, joy. God mounts his throne.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy.
Shouts of joy, joy, joy. God mounts his throne.
shouts of joy announce his throne. Two shouts of joy, 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 God bless his throne. Let us now acclaim a God as ruler of the world. Let the nations know God's reign is here. God bless his throne. Two shouts of joy.
From the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead, and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him his head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached them and said, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Jesus Christ. The celebration of the Ascension of the Lord marks the beginning of a transitional time in our liturgical year. Jesus has gone up to heaven, The disciples did not fully understand all that Jesus had told them. They were unsure of how to move forward. We know that the Holy Spirit came down from heaven as a gift from the Father and the Son to guide and strengthen them. We will be celebrating that event at Pentecost next weekend. But at the time Jesus ascended into heaven, the disciples did not know how exactly the Father was going to send the Holy Spirit to them. So they needed to wait and see. In that way, they began a transitional time. Here at Transfiguration, we too are literally in a transitional time. We had been closed to the public for weeks. Now we must move to gradually open again. There are many regulations that we must follow, such as social distancing and wearing masks. Even so, it will be great to have more people here for the celebration of Mass. Still, it will be a transitional time until we will come back to normality. Our economy is also in a transition period. We need to have economic growth to bring necessary jobs for people here and around the world. Some people are looking to have any job. Some are looking for better jobs. During it all, we are hoping for the development of a coronavirus vaccine. We all want to be safe, healthy, and get back to our regular lives. So we are waiting for things to improve, and as such, we all are in a transitional period. Times of transition are hard. There is a lot of uncertainty about what is coming next. There is a lot of waiting. Should we act now or delay for a while? Like the disciples after Jesus went to heaven, we are wondering what happens next. I invite you to spend some time this week meditating about that period of transition. Before Jesus ascended into heaven, he told his disciples, "Wait for the promise of the Father." The disciples and our Blessed Mother Mary went to the upper room and prayed. In their uncertainty, they waited for the Holy Spirit to come to them. They waited, but they were not inactive. They spent their transitional time in prayer. The reason Jesus asks us in our daily lives and at this transitional moment in our history to be prudent. He certainly is asking us to pray for the gift of the Holy Spirit to come to our aid and lead us. We have to pray before we begin a new journey, before making decisions about our futures, and to pray to be blessed in everything that we do in our lives. Then we are sometimes called to patiently wait and pray for the right moment to act. Right now, especially after our forced period of inactivity, We want to act, to do something, anything. Some people don't want to wait anymore. But for some people, it is much wiser to wait and pray before they move forward. Once we experience the promise of the Father in our lives and we know for sure that the time is right to begin again, then it is okay for us to move forward with our plans. The Holy Spirit will give us the strength to get through these transitional times and continue our mission of spreading the good news of Jesus and doing the right thing in our lives. We don't often know how long transitional periods in our lives will last. But if we take Jesus' advice to wait and pray, we will be given both direction and the strength to move forward. The Holy Spirit is here, ready to take us from transition to transformation. We will be able to continue Jesus' mission to make disciples and do good with our lives. May God bless you. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, in a spirit of humility, aware of God's love and mercy, let us offer our prayers. And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the church. May we be about the work of the Lord until he returns to us. In the ascended Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish on this feast of the Ascension, help all of us to recall our ministry to one another, to the stranger, and to those in need. In the ascended Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our troubled world, protect all people from the pandemic, natural disasters, and terrorism. Bless those who watch over us to keep us safe. In the ascended Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, may all Americans remain mindful of the actions necessary to stop the spread of the virus, not for their own sake, but for the protection of others. In the ascended Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, for those who are terminal, and for all caregivers who watch over them. May they know that the Spirit of God is with them. In the ascended Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Lucy, Martin Cortez, Helen Marie Tunink, Michael Thompson, Keith Coleman, for whom this Mass is offered. In the ascended Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Winifred Bridget Gallagher Kresman, Alvin Hall, and Barb Harris. May the peace of God enfold them and lead them to eternal joy. We also pray on this Memorial Day weekend for all men and women who have sacrificed their lives for our country and for our protection. In the ascended Lord, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for your own intentions held in the silence of your heart.
Let us pray for a peaceful and safe transition from the closed doors of the church to partially open, let's say. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, who is ever faithful, help us to tirelessly strive to be good disciples as we await our Savior's return. Hear these prayers and grant them through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Let us pray. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, may holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you had held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John Hartmeyer, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Bread of life, you take
the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
For those of you joining us online, please join with me in an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive honor and glory. Worthy are the ones who believe to receive the goodness of God. Worthy are you, O Paschal Lamb, wisdom and strength belong now to you. You laid down your life.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who allowed those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord. Now we are going to sing God Bless America. Memorial Day. We are very thankful for all those who serve in the armed forces, and especially thankful for those who gave their lives in service to our country. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Difference.